All right, this is how to use Rhymecraft to record the rhythm of a particular song. So once you log in and you've paid, you click on this link at the top, the Lyrics Rhythm Recorder. Once you're here, so I'm going to click a new song. You see this, we don't need these for the moment. You're going to put the lyrics in. So you go to this button, type, paste, lyrics. And so what you do is you put a genius and you do Eminem. We're going to do the rap god. Okay. Copy that. Paste it in here. And you want to get rid of anything that you're not going to use. You can keep these. These are going to get ignored. Anything in brackets is going to get ignored. In this case, what I want to do, I've already tried this before I made this video, so I know what changes I want to make. I want to make a new line there. I want to make a new line here. And I want to get rid of this. But this is going to take some iteration on your part to decide like which lines you need and which lines you don't want to keep. So once you've gotten the lyrics set up the way you want, you click this button, Submit Lyrics. I'll copy this just in case you want to change something. And now you're seeing the normal lyrics. And what you can do from this window is you can click on a lyric and you can delete that word, or you can add a new word before it or after it. But what we want to do is we want to syllabify the lyrics. We want to break up the lyrics into syllables. So you should double check that the lyrics are all correct. But once you have, you click this checkbox, and then you click syllabify lyrics. And when that is done, you should get shown this screen that shows all of the lyrics broken up into syllables. And from here, you can click on a syllable. You can see the word that it corresponds to, and you can see where in that word it is broken up into different syllables. So you can add new syllables. You can see that it's being changed here. Or you can get rid of syllables. You can make it all one syllable. So it's something you can change depending on what works best. And so what you then want to do is you want to make sure that the syllables are all correct. And I recommend that you listen to the whole song, you know, slowly to make sure that the syllables are all exactly the way they are. Because a lot of the times, or some of the time, you're going to have a word that can be pronounced either as one syllable or as two syllables, or as, you know, multiple syllables. But let's just assume that we've already done that. Then what you need to do is you need to get the song. So you copy the YouTube link, you go to this website, flvto.biz. It's the YouTube converter. You paste in the video here, you check this box saying you agree, and you convert it to an MP3. And then wait for that to finish. And you're going to need Dropbox for this. In the future, I'm going to change it so you don't need Dropbox, but for now, you need Dropbox. So then you download. And we're just waiting for it. It's a bit slow. All right, I'm going to skip that. Let's assume that it's already downloaded. I'm just going to copy it from where I have it already. Okay, so let's assume that that finished. So then what you do is you copy the Dropbox link. You go down here, copy Dropbox link. You wait for the Dropbox to tell you that it worked. See here. And then you go back to Rhymecraft, you go to record the timing, and here's where you paste in the audio link for the song. But you have to change this at the beginning. You have to change the www.dropbox to instead say dl.dropboxusercontent.com. See? And then you click load. And this should pop up saying that it's found the song. It should have the length of the song. There we go. So now it's, you can see that it's 6 minutes and 9 seconds long. That means the song has loaded. And then what you do is, at this point, you can pretty much just tap out the lyrics. I recommend before you tap out the lyrics that you figure out what the BPM is. That'll make the graph look good. So you have this other thing, this graph that shows the syllables after you have tapped them out. And in order for this graph to look right, you need to have the BPM set correctly. So you don't have to do it now, but I think it's just to demonstrate it, I'll show you how you that do that. So you click play on the song.
Look,
Okay.
I was going to go easy
And
on
you
you,
click in
not to hurt your
here,
feelings, but I'm
and you
only
just
going to
tap
get this
one.
one chance.
Dun, dun, dun,
Something
dun,
is wrong. I can feel
dun.
It.
Okay, I'm gonna start.
A feeling.
One, two,
Like something is
three,
about to happen,
four,
but I don't know what.
Two,
If that
three,
means what I think it
four,
means, we're in
one,
trouble. Big
two,
trouble. And it
three,
is bananas,
four,
as you say.
one,
I'm not taking
two,
any chances.
You were just about to
start. I'm beginning to feel like a rat god. Rat god. All my people from the front to the back. Now, back now.
All right, well, you can do it as much or as little as you want. If you do it more, this estimate's going to get more accurate. But that should be fine for now. So now we're going to tap out the lyrics. But in order to do this, we're going to slow down the song because it's too difficult to do it at full speed. And in Eminem's case, it's too difficult to do it at half speed. So we're going to do it at a quarter of the normal speed. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this value to one quarter of its normal value. And I did the math before, and I think it's 18 and a half. 18 and a half BPM is 1/4 of the 74 BPM. And so now I'm going to move this audio back to the start. I'm going to change this drop down that chooses the speed of the audio. I'm going to change it to this 0.25. That's going to play the audio at a quarter speed. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to click play, and then I'm going to click in this box here. And once I click in this box, the application is listening to my key presses on my keyboard. And whenever I press on the keyboard, it's going to register a new syllable, and it's going to register that syllable as being sustained for the same duration that I sustain my key press. So if I hold the key down for a second, the syllable will be recorded as having been for a second. Or, I mean, in this case, since we're doing everything at a quarter speed, it'll be like a quarter of whatever that value is. So if I hold it for 4 seconds, that'll be like 1 second. That's a little bit confusing, but basically you hold down the key for as long as you hear the syllable. That's all you need to know. And then after we have recorded all of the syllables, we're going to speed them up again, speed everything up before we create the video. So let's just start the thing, and you'll see what I'm talking about. And also look here to see the current syllable. I'm going to make that look nicer, but for now you can look there. All right, let's start.
Look, I was gonna go easy on you, not to hurt your feelings, but I'm
misclick there. Okay, well, you get the idea. So I did not do that very perfectly, not even close. This is going to get easier the better you know the song. So if you've tried a few times, you're going to get more and more accurate as you learn the timing. It's especially tricky because you're listening to it at a quarter speed, and so you can't rely on your muscle memory of what the song sounds like. So once you do that, you need to save the song. So we're going to call this Rap God by Eminem. The album is whatever, doesn't matter. Save it. And oh, before you forget, so before we generate this thing, you can see the graph looks a little bit weird. So what we're going to do is we're going to change it back to full speed. So we recorded it at quarter speed, but we want the video to be at a full speed. So what we do is we go to this option here. So I went to this tap for BPM and I clicked advanced, and I go to this option, change BPM of tapped out timing. And you're going to do a ratio. So you're going to do, it was 1 and we're going to change it to 4. So we're changing it from quarter speed to full speed. You know, you could change it. You could also type out here 0.25 to 1. So you click this button. And now everything is showing up too quick because we have the BPM set to the old BPM. But if we change the BPM to the real beep, the new BPM, now you can see that it looks sort of normal. Right, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to save the song. And now it should be ready to create a video. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this Generate Lyrics Video button. And this gives you a bunch of options. I'm going to say that I just want to test out, say, the last 10 seconds. So we recorded up until the 24th second. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start this at the 10th second. So that's 10,000 milliseconds. And I'm going to record up to, say, 15,000 milliseconds. So 15 seconds. Frames per second, you can choose the image width, the image height, the background image. That's not working yet, but it will be. Background color, background filter I need to get working. Basically, you're just going to want to mess around with the start time and the end time. You can also change the colors. That's all working, and the font size is working. Okay, so if you only want one syllable at a time to show up on the screen, you uncheck this option, showing the entire line of lyrics. If you check it, then you will see the entire line of lyrics, and the current syllable will be highlighted. So then you click Create Lyrics Video, and the lyrics video will then be it will go through the process of being created. Now, if you want to see the status, you click on this Finished Lyrics Videos button here, and you'll see the current status of the video that you have asked to be created. So right now it's creating the frames. After it creates the frames, it's going to combine the frames into a video and then add the audio. And then it'll be done and you can download it. So if I click again, here we go, combining frames into a soundless video. This status does not currently update if you leave this window open. So you have to close the window and then open it again. I will change that at some point, but I haven't yet. So that's done. Creating a cropped audio file, waiting for that to finish. Finished, here we go. So now I can click this. It downloads, I open it.
6 minutes, I can feel it.
It's just a feeling I got. Like something's.
And then you can see it's working. So you can see it's working. And so that's how you do it. So you just repeat that. You just go through that same process if you want to do the whole song. It is very difficult if you want to do a long song or if you want to do a song that's wrapped very quickly. Or it's more difficult, I should say. And yeah, that's the whole process. Don't think I'm forgetting anything.